Welcome to Office 2013, video number 5. Hey, we're at our website, and we're about to download a file. If you click on the link below the video, you can get to this website. And here it is. We've our fifth video, and we have a start file. None of the projects we've done so far had a file that we actually started with. So we're going to download this. When the Save As dialog opens, I'm going to look on the left. Well, I already put my jump drive in, so I'm going to expose either with the pluses and minuses or the triangles and dig down, Highline, the quarter you're in, Business 216 class notes, and we're talking about Word, so I'm going to save it, boop, to the Word folder. I see this is the file we created last video. I'm going to click Save. Now, I'm in Chrome. I could click on this and open it, or I could Window E to open up Windows Explorer and dig down. You could also open up Word and go open and find it this way. I tend to use Windows Explorer when I'm looking for something. All right, so now I see it over here. Notice this looks just like that Save As dialog box we just used. I'm going to double click and open this. Now notice it's the start file. Double click open. It says start file in the title bar. I'm immediately going to save as because I want to keep this. This is the blank. This is the text we're going to use for this flyer project. We're going to do a bunch of formatting and insert a picture and look at page setup. So I immediately want to save it. F12 is, I meant, immediately want to save as. You could see, oh, it's grayed out, but up here in the address bar, I can see the complete file path. I'm going to change the name. I'm going to keep the same file extension. I'm going to type something like flyer finished or health food flyer finished. Click Save. All right. Our goal here is to create a flyer for Cornucopia Health Food Store. They're having a grand opening. Now, to start off, we're going to do some formatting, insert a picture. I want to highlight all the text, increase the font, center all the text, and then change the size of the margins. All right, so how do we select all the text? Well, we could go up to the home rimming, editing, select all, or we could use our keyboard Control A. Now we'd like to increase the font size. Now we can do this a couple ways. Home ribbon, font group. Remember, all of this is font or character level formatting. And we can use our drop down to change the font size. Or escape, we can use a keyboard. Now you have to find the square brackets on your keypad. They're kind of above Enter and below Backspace. Control close square bracket will increase the font size. Control open square bracket will decrease. Now watch up here. It'll increment it one font size at a time. Control close square bracket, close, close, close. So I'm going to go until I see a 20 there. Next, we want to center everything. That's a paragraph level formatting. So we'd come here and click on Center. Or you can use the keyboard Control E. The next thing is we want to change the margins. Now the margins are how far from the edge of the paper in are you allowed to start. Now this is a section level formatting. And we'll talk more about section level formatting in Chapter 2 when we do research papers. But we can get to page layout. And we want the page setup dialog box by clicking this dialog launcher. Remember, there's a keyboard for this. If page setup is something you do all the time, then you want to learn your keyboard. Alt, I see that P, I see that SP. So Alt PSP. You can either do that keyboard or click that dialog launcher. And then here's the margins. Top, I'm going to say 0.5. To move to the next text box in a dialog box, hit Tab, 0.5 for the bottom, Tab, 0.5 for left, Tab, 0.5. If you want to go back in a dialog box, it's Shift Tab, Shift Tab, Shift Tab. Tab goes forward, Shift Tab goes back. That works in most websites, like if you're buying a ticket at southwest.com, an airplane ticket. It also will work in Word tables and in Excel also. Tab will go forward, Shift-Tab will go back. We'll also see that it does something cool in PowerPoint. Tab will go forward. Shift-Tab will go backwards. All right, so page setup is a section level formatting. We change the margins. Click OK. Now look at this. Immediately you can see that this was on two lines, and now it's a single line. Why? Because we changed the margins. We went from 1.25 inches to 0.5. All right, so we did some section level formatting, changing the margins. We did some paragraph level formatting, centering all the paragraphs. And then we did some character level formatting, changing the font. Now I'd like to do some more character level formatting to these first two paragraphs, the text in the first two paragraphs. I'm going to come over here to the selection bar and click and drag to highlight those first two lines. Now I'd also like to, I want to skip over that paragraph mark. I want to highlight this grand opening. Now I could do it with my I-beam or over here in the selection bar, but I'm holding Control. I've highlighted things not next to each other called non-contiguous. And now I'm going to use my keyboard, Control, close square bracket, and increase. Now that's, I can't see what that is. I'm going to come over to Home. That's 32. I'm now going to decrease just these two using my Control key. Now I could highlight with the I-beam and then hold Control and highlight with the I-beam, or use my selection bar. And then I'm going to down square bracket, so Control, open square bracket. These two will be a little bit smaller. All right, now I'm going to highlight the first two paragraphs. And I would like to add in the paragraph group on the Home ribbon some fill, and this will fill the whole paragraph. I'm going to select a really dark blue. Now notice the text is black. When I select this super dark fill, the text changed to white. All right, now I'm going to scroll down a little bit, look at the bottom. And in fact, you know what? Let's zoom in just to one page. And there's a great feature on the view I can go to in the zoom group, one page. Boop. And now I can see on one page. Now that's a little bit too small, so I'm going to hold Control and roll. What I'd like to do down here is everything centered, but at the bottom I'd like to not have it centered. I'd like to have it aligned to the left. So I'm going to click there, and I could use my I-beam and click and drag. Or I could realize that I'm going to highlight all the way to the bottom. We know that Control N would jump to the end. So my cursor was here in Control End. If I just hold Shift there, then I can highlight all the way to the end, Control Shift End. And now I'd like to align this to the left. Go up to Home, and then there's the left. If you could imagine, the keyboard would be Control L for left. Usually alignment is not a keyboard that you need to memorize. All right, so it says huge selection. Every day, all year round. I would like to separate this text up here from this. So I'm going to put my cursor after free samples all day long and hit Enter. Now, tofu, carb, herbal teas, all of these on like a bulleted list. So I'm going to select from the beginning of tofu all the way to the end. I could use my I-beam cursor and drag, or I could use Control Shift End. Now, bullets. That's a paragraph level formatting. Actually, every time you hit Enter, a new bullet would be added. We'll talk about bullets and numbering and outlines later. But here I just want a bullet. So there we go. Now, this huge selection every day or all year long, I'd like to highlight and come up and add some fill. I'm going to add a blue, but a little bit lighter blue. Then I'm going to change the font color to white. All right, so we have some basic formatting. We could do a lot more with this, and the textbook list does a lot more with formatting. But let's see how to insert a picture. And I actually want to make sure my cursor is right below the blue. I'm going to hit Enter, Enter, and then up arrow. All right, and I can see I have some room down here, because when I insert a picture, it's going to push everything down. All right, so to insert a picture, we're going to go up to the Insert Ribbon tab. Illustrations group, this has changed. There used to be a clip art button, but no longer. There's a picture button. That'll allow you to get pictures from this computer. Now, in the textbook, they'll ask you to use a particular picture that they want of a dog or a baseball player. Don't worry about it. You put whatever picture you want, And look at this. This is online pictures. So we can just go search online. Now, before I do that, let's come down here. Double click the word cornucopia. That selects the word. Control C to copy. I'm going to search for cornucopia. Now, I've selected that word. I want to make sure to put my cursor down here, my flashing cursor, because that's where I want the picture to go. Click Online Pictures. I have office.com clip art to search, and I could also search Bing for images. In that text box, Control V, Enter, and a bunch of options come up. You could scroll down and find which one you want. I'm going to select this one right here. I could click the Insert button or simply double click. All right, so the picture is inserted right where we wanted it. This layout option buttons comes up. If we click it, we can decide what type of word wrap we want. Right now, the default is it's going to consider this picture just like a single letter within a line of text. If we wanted to wrap it in a square or tight, or even top and bottom, have the image behind or in front, we could set the word wrap in layout options. Close. In this case, this picture is a little bit small, and I definitely want to make it a little bit bigger. So I'm going to point to one of the corners. And when I see that diagonal arrow, I can click and drag, make it bigger. And then I'm going to scroll down to make sure I didn't go to the next page. Another thing we're not going to do here, but maybe you would like to do sometime. You know, we have all these pictures in this day and age, and we might want to insert a cool picture we took into Word, but maybe it's not cropped correctly. Well, the picture tool's format allows us over in the size to crop. Now, cropping will change the outline of the picture. Once you see those black lines, you can click on one of the corners or the edges. Click and drag. Now, it's not resizing. It's actually cropping. We don't want that here, so I'm going to Control Z. Format ribbon's kind of cool. And in the textbook, you do some of these effects. There's actually some nice ones here. You could select that one. Actually, that one's not nice. I think maybe this one's looking good. All right, and so then boom. For us, that's not going to work. Control Z to undo. All right, and if I click outside, the crop marks will go away. So we have our picture. Now, we'd like to add one more thing. I'm going to scroll up a little bit. We want to add a page border to really bring some attention to this. The problem is we already did margins in our page setup dialog box. So when you try to do page borders, it'll be too crowded. But let's put the page borders in and then see if we can fix it. Now, where are page borders? We can go to Design. And over in the page background, we have page borders. That'll bring up the borders and shading dialog box with the page border tab showing. I want to show you another way to access that, because a lot of times you're working on the home ribbon. Here's borders. Borders, if you select the dropdown, there's some defaults. But you can come down here to borders and shading. And all of these borders are either paragraph. So if you have your cursor in the paragraph and you do a border like that, it highlights the entire paragraph, Control Z. Or if you have just some text and then you select this, it'll put a border around just the text, Control Z. So opening up from the paragraph group on the home ribbon, borders and shading, will bring you, and then you can do some fancier borders for either the paragraph or the text, or you can get straight to page border. Now let's do a page border. It just puts it all the way around the page. I'm going to say a box. You could select your style, your color, width, and here's the one we're going to use, art. And there's all sorts of options here. I'm going to go ahead and select the stars. Now, 30 is probably a little bit too big, so I'm going to use my down arrow, go down to, say, 15. I'm going to click OK. And clearly, we can see we adjusted the margins too much. But no problem. Page layout, remember, page setup, dialog launcher, or Alt-PSP. Alt-PSP. Now, notice it's highlighting top. I'm going to type a 1 tab, 1 tab, 1 tab, 1. And notice down here, dialog buttons This is a dialog box. And usually in dialog boxes, there's one of the buttons that either has a blue shadow or a black one. That means if you hit Enter, it will enact that button. So if I hit Enter, and that looks much better. I'm going to hold Control and Roll to see it all on one screen. Oh, wait a second. We need to do some fixing. And this is often the case where something's hanging off into the next page. Let's see. Let's get rid of that. Right there, I clicked on that paragraph mark, and then I'm going to hit the Delete key. I'm going to click right there, and when I delete it, it'll suck this one up. Boop. Let's see, 9 a.m., so first 50 customers. And then maybe we'll get rid of this one. And sure enough, that pulls it up. Now, let me turn the non-printing characters off, Control-Shift-8. And let's just for a second look at this and pretend you didn't see that. Here we have our nicely formatted flyer. But why is there an extra page? Right? Well, if you have your non-printing characters turned on, either Home and then that button over there or Control-Shift-8, you can clearly see that there is a hard return hanging out on the next page. So if I'm up here, I can simply hit Delete, and it sucks it right up. All right, I'm going to Control S. That saved just the latest changes. Now, let's take a look at Print. Control P opens up Print. And since 2010, they have the Print dialog box and Print Preview together. We can clearly see page 1 of 1. It's looking good. A few options here. We can select how many copies. There's the Print button. We can select which printer if we have a choice. Here's some options depending on your printer. And this one right here is pretty interesting. And look at that. It's slipping off the page there. So I'm going to scroll down. We can print all pages, the current page only, or select a custom number of pages, 5 to 6. Also, print selection. Now, that's grayed out. But if you highlight just one paragraph, you can print out just that one paragraph by printing selection. I'm going to click Escape. And this is Backstage View for Print. We're not going to print it. I'm going to click Escape. Another thing we want to take a look at, in the paragraph group, we have some colors. There's our fill colors. And in the font group, we have some font colors. Now, those are the default colors. But those can be changed. If you go over to Design, the Theme, depending on which theme you choose, and Themes, Style Sets, Colors, and Fonts, these are a way of applying consistent formatting. Not only that, but if you like Berlin, Berlin will show up also in PowerPoint and Excel also. Now, we're in here in Word. If I select Berlin and go over and look, that has completely changed the colors that appear in my dropdowns. So whatever theme you choose will determine the colors that show up, again, in PowerPoint, Excel, and Word. If you want to go back to the default, you click Office. All right, that's it for this video. We created a flyer in this video. We saw some cool formatting. We saw font or character level formatting, paragraph level formatting, section level formatting. We saw this cool page border, inserted a picture, saw some keyboards, or actually a bunch of keyboards to do formatting. Oh, that's a lot. Next video, we'll actually do spell check. And you won't believe it. There's some pretty cool tricks for spell check. All right, see you next video.